Hello, this is Roy, and for my third blah blah, I have chosen The Yellow Submarine by the Beatles. One interesting aspect of modern musicology, or at least the creation of music, is the way in which musical groups use the studio environment to create a work or an object of musicianship. And the Yellow Submarine, I believe, is interesting from the way in which it utilizes different sonic construction in the studio to arrive at a aural world. Very basically, the Yellow Submarine is credited to Lennon and McCartney with lead vocals by Ringo Starr. It was produced by George Martin and engineered by Joriff Immerich. The Yellow Submarine was finished after five takes on the 26th of March, 1966, Studio 2 at the Albany Road Studios, with special effects being added June 1st, 1961. Here I'm going to utilize the scholarship of Alan D. Pollack and his groundbreaking series Notes on the Beatles. He states, and this is a direct quote, "The deployment of the sound effects here would be cute enough no matter where they came from, but the fact that the Beatles themselves took trouble in synthesizing and participating in them adds value. It is also worth recalling just what an attention-grabbing curveball this song appeared to be in context of its initial release. Sure, the Beatles had been growing ever more difficult to pigeonhole for a while by mid-1966, but the appearance of this song, with Ella Marigny, is no less promise to the limit. Could anyone other than the Beatles get away with this? Try to imagine Yellow Submarine at the first or second song of a no-name group." Very basically, and I'm going to quote from my sources, which was both Wikipedia and several other history of song sites. For the first quote, this comes from Wikipedia. On the second session, special effects were employed in which band members and guests participated, which includes chains, a ship's bell, tap dancing mats, whistles, hooters, a tin bath filled with water, wind, and thunderstorm machine, as well as a cash register, which was later used on Pink Floyd's song Money, according to the Wikipedia site. Lennon blew through a straw into a pan of water to create a bubbling effect. McCartney and Lennon talked through tin cans to create the sound of intercom chatter, and Albany Road employees John Skinner and Terry Cotton twirled chains in a tub, in a tin bath to create water sounds. This is very reminiscent of Foley sound in movies, where you create like the sonic environment of the film. The sound effects can definition of how the sound effects done continue on the secondary sides. John spoke through the back of his Vox amp in order to sing along with the final verse. John Skinner and Terry Cotton of Albany Road Studios twirled chains in a bathtub to create the ocean, and the session invited musical guests, in addition to singing along with the chorus, to create a party atmosphere around which it all, as cited by the Yellow Submarine, the history of this classic Beatles song. After the line and the band begins to play, Emmerich found a recording of a bass brand and changed it slightly so it could not be identified. Although it is thought to be a recording of George Currier and Charles Hermer's 1960 composition, Le Rêve Passé, this was also stated in some of the anomalies of the song that the player of the tuba begins a trill before they even say the band begins to play, showing that there is a mix match in the editing of this file, or I should say tape, from the vault. To stay with the children's story theme, the original recording had a spoken intro by Starr. This idea was scrapped, but it was described that the verse was written in a Fox medieval poetry style, and this poem was written and used for a charity almost 2 to 3 months before this song was finished being completed in composition. Following this slide will be a sample of the section of the Yellow Submarine that utilizes the most sound effects to show how the use of the sound effects one is not does not know just how much a musical composition is the sum of its parts and how these differing use of sound effects increase and add to the musicianship of the song in question. Thank you.
And our friends are all aboard. Many more of them live next door. And the band begins to play. We all live in a yellow submarine. Yellow submarine. Yellow submarine. We all
These are the web sources that I used for this blah blah. I would suggest that anyone interested more in the history of the song and especially the sound effects try some of these URLs and website sources for a fuller exploration of the sound effects in the Yellow Submarine. Thank you very much, and you have a good day. Roy signing off.